Good evening, everyone. We are delighted to have all of you at this 79th birthday party of our living legend, Congressman Danny K. Davis, hosted by Multiethnic Advisory Task Force. At this special evening, we want to acknowledge the MEATF Executive Leadership Team, Dr. Sinobia Sowell, MEATF Women's Chair, Ms. Masantos Kumar, MEATF Gala Chair 2020, Dr. Srinivas Reddy, MEATF Gala Sar 2020, Mr. Kishore Mehta, MEATF Emeritus Chairman, Dr. Clarence Beals, MEATF Member Secretary, and our own Gerard Moore is here. And last but not least is Dr. Vijay Prabhakar, MEATF Founder Chairman, and the catalyst for all of us. Tonight, we are delighted to welcome all MEATF members. Thanks so much also to our host, Mr. Niranjan Natawi of the Big Suchir Restaurant, and the saxophonist Femi Ogribole. Enjoy this wonderful birthday bash. And God bless all of you. God bless America. We'll start with the opening prayers by Dr. Sinobia Sowell.
Thank you for this day. We thank you for the celebration of one of your servants, Congressman Danny K. Davis. Father, for what he means to you and what he has given and means to each one of us. We ask you to continue to bless him, his family, his wife, and Father, all that he's done and all that he's doing. We thank you that he is a servant of the people, which means he's your servant. And we just say thank you and we praise you for his life, for his giving, his unselfish spirit. Father, we ask that you just continue to give him long life, that he serves in the ways that you have given him and imparted your gifts to him. We just bless your name today. And we thank you that each one here, Father, will be an impetus, Father, for the dreams and the visions that you've placed in him to carry out for the goodness of this world and for the kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Indian traditional welcome by Sri Guru Sami and Dipti Shah. Please come forward.
This Aarti meaning is Hindu religion of ritual of worship, and this one is give lighten in your life, and God is give you happy, healthy and prosperous birthday to you today.
Thank you.
We can sing happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you.
Can vote.
Happy birthday to our living legend, Congressman Danny K. Davis. I am Zainab Tabasi Bibi and I'm the student wing chair of MEATF and AMAC. I'm from Hyderabad, the throne of the Nawabs. And today we are going to honor Danny K. Davis with the Nawabi tradition. So may I please request MEATF Princess Rani Yousafzai to escort our founder chairman, Dr. Vijay Prabhakar, founder chairman of MEATF and AMAC, to crown our living legend, Congressman Danny K. Davis.
Ceremony is a presentation of sandalwood garland
to Arjuna,
the eternal fragrance. Chandi presented by oldest member of MEATF Executive Council, 78-year-old Najendra Sribada, along with Jerome Asirchan, our treasurer.
say a few words first. What's the basic of it?
Happy birthday to Congressman Danny Davis. May God bless you with a long life.
You are so special, a living legend and an angel. They say wisdom comes with aging, but you were born wise. The energy you bring is always positive and always nice. Today is a very special day for all of us. It's your birthday and we celebrate here to show how much we care. Happy birthday!
Davis, you know, whenever we see him or think about him, such a feeling comes of a family member and such a dear and such a close thing. And you know that, as Vrita has said, that you are born wise. Definitely you are born wise.
Yes.
There's no doubt about it. And if I can take you in my birth country, India, I think many, many young people can encourage to be a politician. Because our people, the good people, remain away from the politics because they think politics is a game of a crooked people, game of a very bad people. They do the wrong things. But since they see you, they can be encouraged and they can do the politics and our country can be better than now. Thank you. Thank you so much for your love, for your care. We wish you a very, very good health and happiness and fulfillment of thing, and want you to be with us for more time. Thank you so much.
Mr. Anas Upadhyaya, come to the States.
Yeah, wish you a very happy birthday, and we will always work with you, and you are very friendly to all our Indian community and all other community. So, thank you very much.
Come and be a friend. You're an inspiration to everybody. You go above and beyond, and you're a legend. I'm so honored to be at your presence. Happy birthday. May God bless you for another 100 years.
Thank you. Mr. Kishore Mehta.
Danny K. Davis, very happy birthday and many, many happy returns of the day. And we wish you many, many more healthy, happy years ahead. Thank you.
Thank you. Congressman, it's our great pleasure to celebrate this wonderful birthday with all of us of the METF family over here. And we are so proud and so happy and lucky to have you with us. Thank you very much. Wishing you a happy birthday.
Thank you.
Wish you a happy birthday. It's an honor and privilege for me to join all of you celebrating Congressman's 79th birthday bash. You know, it's a special day for all of us because Congressman has dedicated most of his life, over 50 years, to the public service for the cause of the common man. It's a special day for all of us because Congressman has worked tirelessly to improve the health of most vulnerable population of the inner city Chicagoland during the most difficult times of this COVID-19 pandemic. It's a special day for all of us because he has tirelessly worked in Washington, D.C., negotiating with the congressional leadership to initiate multiple governmental programs, stimulus package, paycheck protection program for many small business people to survive in these difficult days. finally, it's a special day. It's very special for all of us to celebrate a person who is very compassionate, committed, hardworking, independent thinking, with a vision to improve human welfare, not only in Illinois, but across the country. You know, I could always say, he is a leader who is open to listening. People of any human being, irrespective of race, religion, and where you came from, that clearly exemplifies tonight of all the people we are seeing, the mix of people all across the country who adore you dearly. And I could say my one anecdote of my personal experience with the Congressman. When I first came about this COVID-19 pandemic in the month of April and May, it was disproportionately affecting a lot of African-American people. As a physician, I wanted to do something, and I actually got involved with the plasma program. During those 2 months, I called the Congressman so many times. He was so receptive and helped the program along the way to help the needy people. You know, one thing that I could say, the stakes could be higher during this election cycle. We need an energetic congressman in Washington, D.C. more than ever during these difficult times. Like everybody, I hope and pray that God to give him good health, energy, and motivation to help the people in need. Thank you, Congressman, and you continue to do the same work you have been doing all your life, and may God bless you.
Years. I really appreciate all the service, all the work that you've given to our community here. And we wish you 100 more years, like just like somebody else said before me, and always smiling, always getting all the community together. And you are one of our pillar who we learn everything under you. We really appreciate it, and God bless.
We would like to have Mr. Ajit Singh to make a presentation to the Congressman.
I'm so humbled to be part of the Multiethnic Coalition Task Force from last 5 years under the leadership of Congressman and Dr. Vijay Prabhakar. And I think we feel that this coalition is like a family, and Congressman, congratulations on 79th birthday. We feel that we are celebrating your 49th birthday, not 79th. So you are so much energetic. So again, congratulations from bottom of our heart. Thank you, Congressman.
Thank you.
Chanting the Sanskrit verses, but at that time I would like to request all of you to raise your hand like this, so your positive vibrations will reach to him and bless him to have a long, long, happy, healthy life, hundreds of years. Om Shatam Inno Sharado Ranti Deva Yatra Raschakra Jara Santanu Namba Putraso Yatra Pitaro Bhavanti Mano Madhyari Rikata Yurganto. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Best, 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 happy, happy, healthy life for hundreds of years, okay?
And I learned a lot today. Every day, whenever I spoke to you, I have been learning something new about you, and some coordination between you and me, what we are doing, what I'm trying to do. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I hope those blessings will be there for me and continue my journey in that. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
We would like to request Ms. Sri Guruswami.
It's a great honor to be here to wish Honorable Congressman Danny Davis. I admire him so much, and I have watched his work in Washington, and I can tell you that he is a true leader who's passionate about everyone in this country. All his legislations, his work in the Congress speaks volumes about how he addresses the racial injustice. He assists people who are incarcerated helping them to rehabilitate them. He also passed legislation supporting access to health care, giving benefits to seniors such as Social Security and Medicare. So he's truly someone who shows it in action, not just, you know, keeps, you know, campaigning and giving speeches. He's a true lawmaker who cares about his constituents. And I think we need a leader like that. And with the upcoming election, I strongly urge each and every one of you, if you can encourage at least five of your friends and your families to vote, and vote for people that value immigrants, that are truthful to their constituents. I think he is somebody that we all can look up to, and I'm blessed to be in your multi-ethnic task force, and I pray to God to give you a long life and continue your work in Congress and keep doing what you're doing, and we will definitely make America great again.
We would like to have Mr. Johnson Suka.
We have two good names, Danny and Davis. Daniel is the bull like lion, and David, man after God's own heart. And I heard everyone was saying about you being wise, I give Daniel 12:3. Let me leave that one word. Those who are wise will shine like the brightness of the heavens, and those who lead many to righteousness, like the stars forever and ever. May God bless you.
Thank you, sir.
One, we would like to have Mr. Tijan Doma.
Happy birthday, Congressman. I'm very honored, and I'm glad I'm part of multi-ethnic task force. This is a really true multi-ethnic task force. And on behalf of United Telugu Christian Community and multi-ethnic Christian community, I congratulate you. You are a role model to the community. This is a really multi-ethnic task force working for the community. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Lafi Gundara Rajat.
First of all, wish you many more happy events on today, Congressman. So it's my pleasure to be here, this part of the METF family in this past 1 year. So under the leadership of Vijay Prabhakar. And so talking about like Congressman, what I would like to say is like, so there will be like a shift. What the research says is like there will be a shift in every decade, like every 8 to 12 years, there will be a shift in people, how people think and how people make their choices and everything. But like in the 7th congressional district, we cannot see that, because it's the same thing. Like people, every generation are coming out, but still they are just voting for Congressman Danny K. Davis, which is like how the relationship has been built up with the people of all generations. It's not only the generation in 1996. So it's a generation of all generations, like even today. So when you see the results of primary, like how he won, still it speaks. So in all generations, they're like, you know, in the support of congressmen, which is like how the relationship has been built. And finally, like talking about the sacrifices. So I've been like studying about like congressmen, and like there are like a lot of sacrifices he has done, not only for the 7th congressional district, not only for Illinois, for the country. And like it would take a lot of time to talk about that. I just keep it for future events. But I'm really proud to be in this team. And so that too for like multi-ethnic task force for Congressman Danny K. Davis. Thank you so much. I wish you again a happy birthday.
Thank you.
We would like to have Mr. Jayanta Mukherjee.
Many, many happy returns of the day to our honorable Congressman Danny K. Davis. You have a wonderful 79th birthday. I am honored to be here with a person, the leader of the mass and leader of the people we need. He is like an example how to lead the people and the country. So wish you many, many more happy birthday, and Congratulations. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'd like to have Dr. C.M. Moody.
I need your blessing. It's such a pleasure to be here for your 79th birthday. We are foundation, Mahatma Gandhi Foundation, and you remind me very much, especially the stick you are carrying. Gandhi carried it all his life.
Wow.
Other reason for this carrying the stick is maybe our coming election, our whatever happens in the election, you are carrying it for the person to beat up somebody. I know. Thank you very much, sir, on behalf of Mahatma Gandhi Foundation. He's also vice president, and we welcome you and thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Gladys.
Much is given, much is expected. You've done so much for us in Africa, especially in Nigeria. If I can count, maybe you've been here about maybe 3-4 times. And that's why in most cases I attend this, you know, because if you've been given much, you're expected to come in and do much in service. You've been of service, of kindness, of simplicity, humility to so many. And we really appreciate you so much. I thank Dr. Prabhakar, you know, for the opportunity of having me on this team. And it means so much to me and my daughter. Recently, my daughter, this year, was given an award, which was even sent to Washington. And the secretary of VA, you know, had to commend her in their executive paper. So everybody knows you are doing a lot, you know, for the common people, and we do appreciate it. We've been campaigning, even though there's been COVID, but we've been campaigning because I'm in the 7th Congressional District. I live right on Michigan Avenue, and it's in your district. So in our building and all around, including my daughter, we've been going knocking on doors and talking to people that they really need to come out and vote for you again. We appreciate you so greatly, especially in this team. It's been a unifying team, making every one of us come together. And you've been a father to all of us, listening and paying attention to us. It means so much to me. Thank you. On behalf of the whole Africa,
I greet you on this day. God has blessed you with 79 years, and we're asking for 100 more. And when I hear the name honorable, it's a title, but when I hear that word honorable, I think of you. Because not only are you honorable as our congressman, you're honorable in the sight of God. And there are other words, compassionate, dedication, wisdom, many of the words and terms that we've heard here tonight. And it just gives me great pleasure to celebrate this day with you amongst all of the MEATF family. And just wish you many more years of service and the desires of your heart. And I just want to share this scripture with you from Jeremiah 29:11. For the Lord says, I know the plans that I have for you, and they're good to bring you an expected end. And so he knows what you have given and what you give, and he will continue to bless you.
Thank you.
For our chairman, Mr. Martin Thongwe, a great job so far. And Congress, please be seated. While we are expecting Congressman Raja Krishnamurthy to join us anytime now, as you know that every year when we celebrate Congressman Danny K. Davis's birthday, we present an annual Congressman Danny K. Davis birthday commemorative award. The previous awardees have been the former Attorney General, Lisa Madigan, the Jackson Park Hospital Chairman, and we would be also having tonight. The awards jury has selected a notable person to receive the Danny K. Davis Commemorative Award. Along with that, Congressman Davis wanted to give a METF COVID-19 and Corona Relief Award to an individual that's done exemplary well. And so that award would also be presented. And also our annual METF Volunteer Service Award. So while we would like to have Congressman Raja here also while the presentation is going on. But without any further ado, I'll call upon Ajit Singh. Could you get him to come? Ajit Singh, our METF Vice Chair. We'll make the announcement for the first awardee. Mr. Ajit Singh will make the announcement for the first awardee, the METF Volunteer Service Awardee. You know, Mr. Ajit Singh is the CEO of Midway Brokers and also partner of Midway Reality, and he's also the Secretary General of the Indian American Business College.
On behalf of Multiethnic Coalition Task Force, CEO of Big Suchir Restaurant and Beautic in Donuts Grove, who organize all this here, and on behalf of Multiethnic Coalition Task Force, we would like to call to Mr. Rajendra Nathwani to the stage and congratulate him for METF Volunteer Service Award 2020. Mr. Nathwani, please come to the stage.
Nathwani, who is the chairman and president of the Big Suchir group of restaurants who have been supplying, please come on stage, sir. For the last 20 years, I will request our chairman to present the medallion to him first, and then the congressman will give the plaque to him.
The pandemic. One of the most hard-hit industries in this country has been our restaurants. You can't imagine the toll that the pandemic has taken. And yet there are those individuals, especially in leadership, who've had enough vision, enough faith, and enough belief to keep things moving and keep things going. This Volunteer Service Award is given to individuals who voluntarily do things, not because they are compensated in the normal way. One of the things I like about myself is that I recall when people really couldn't know what I did in terms of what my job was, because I just did what I did. Whether I was employed by anybody or not. Before I got elected, I guarantee you a lot of folks didn't know who I worked for. They just know I did things. And so to give an award to the CEO in recognition of steadfast devotion and service to the community for the past 20 years and more. Two decades. But just to say thank you in reality. I mean, there is so much that people don't understand about the world in which we live. Those who give of themselves consistently without thought to their personal being, but who give because they love to give, who have an agape kind of feeling about life. They love not because they always loved in return. They love because they have a need to love. And it's not the reciprocal need that most of us feel when we think of giving. You give me something, I give you something. I scratch your back, you scratch mine. That's reciprocity. But when you give of yourself because you have a need to give, that's love. And so volunteerism is love in action.
Wow.
We're proud to present this recognition of your service on behalf of the Multiethnic Advisory Task Force, and we say thank you.
Thank you, Congressman. Happy birthday. Thank you for coming in our place. We're glad you come. Mr. Nick Verma recommend first time to we do the event here. I was so happy. Glad. Thank you everyone to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Nirjanathani. Thank you very much.
We welcome Congressman Raja Krishnamurthy. Please give a big round of applause. And we go along and we request now Dr. Rani Yusuf Sai, who's healthcare entrepreneur. Please come, Raja, please come out here.
Congratulations.
We'll request Congressman Raja Krishnamurthy to present the METF medallion to Kishore Mehta. And then the congressman.
Congratulations,
Kishore
Ji. Wow. You know, good things come in pairs. And so to the Mehta family, Kishore and his wonderful mate. We're going to present this award to you for the leadership that you have provided, for the inspiration that you provide, for the vision that you display, and you continuously give of yourself in such a way that you really help to make our world a better place in which to live. And so on this day, Sunday, September 6th, which also happens to be the day that I came into the world, I make this presentation to you and say thank you for all that you are, all that you have been, and all that you will continue to be. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, Rani, for wonderful introduction and kind words. Congressman, it's my lucky day, and I'm so happy to have two congressmen blessing me and awarding me. I consider it my good luck. And I thank both congressmen for awarding me. Thank you so much. Now, Congressman Danny Davis, you've been our leader for METF for all these years. You have given us guidance and encouraged us to do large hard work to promote humanity everywhere. So I thank you for that. Congressman Raja, thank you so much for taking your time and coming out for this special event for Congressman Davis's birthday and awarding me. Thank you, I appreciate it. I also wanted to thank our dynamic leader, Vijayji, who has planned this whole event, as you all know. Without that, nothing happens. And I also wanted to thank him for considering me for considering my name to submit to our committee, and I wanted to thank committee also for approving my award. Thank you so much. Last but not the least, I wanted to thank my wife, who has been helping me and supporting me for all my progress and putting up with me for all these years. Thank you. Once again, my METF family, thank you so much for all your love and everlasting support. I thank each and every one of you. Thank you so much.
Hello, beta, come closer.
Next, a very strong Democrat, the Naperville City Housing Commissioner, Shri Gursami, Kamala Harris Delegate and also METF Executive Leadership Council to announce the special award which the Congressman has had for the METF COVID-19 Hero Award.
Hello everyone. It's my privilege and honor to announce this award to my dear, dear mentor and someone I respect so much since I've known her, Mrs. Santosh Kumar.
Oh.
And I just want to say a few words about her. I know you all know about her work in this community and what she's done for seniors in Chicago. I just want to highlight something that she just recently did, which I know Congressman also knows about it. She took it upon herself to increase engagement with the ethnic community of Chicago and bring awareness about the U.S. Census 2020. Her organization has reached out to so many people to make them aware of the census and helping them complete the form. And also she's done so much for thousands of seniors with all her different programs. So we wish her all the best and may God bless her and her family with a long life and she continue to serve the seniors of our city.
Please read the plaque.
The plaque says, U.S. Congressman Danny K. Davis presents the METF COVID-19 Relief and Rescue Hero 2020 Award to Ms. Santosh Kumar, Founder and Executive Director of Metropolitan Asian Family Services. In recognition of her dedication, commitment, and passion in rendering outstanding service and care to several hundred senior citizens of Chicagoland, through her agencies, MAFS and UMAS. Her tireless service over the last 6 months to the South Asian senior citizens is truly amazing. On this day, September 6, 2020.
We'll request Congressman Danny and Mrs. Raja Krishnamurti to present the medallion to Mrs. Kumar and then Congressman Dana Davis will present
the medallion. Single person that someone convinced to fill out their census form, or if they convinced a family who may not have filled it out. Each person is worth between $14,000 and $18,000 to the state of Illinois and to the community in which we live, coming from the federal government. So just imagine that if you were to convince 10 people who otherwise would not have filled out the form, you're talking about $200,000 that we get from the federal government that we would not have. And so to work with our senior population, who oftentimes aren't certain and are not sure. I tell you, before I came here this evening, I was out promoting census. I have a great big bus that we were on, driving through neighborhoods, asking people to fill out the census form or to call in and make sure that they were signed up. Your understanding of the realities of life in our communities is so profound, so worthwhile, and so worthy. Until we are pleased and proud to present to you this acknowledgement of your work. And I know those who call you the Mother Teresa. So Mother Teresa, we present to you this award in recognition of your outstanding vision and work, and thank you so very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Congressman Dave Davis, Arms and Raja Krishnamurti, and all Dr. Vijay Prabhakar and the whole team of Meetup. I'm so humbled, and I'm speechless basically what to say in this occasion, because the pandemic, when it hit us, it was so difficult and we were so worried how we can serve the vulnerable population, that is seniors, because seniors are the most needed, and but they cannot come out, and how to reach out. And I want to thank the government of our Illinois and the nation, that they have provided so much programs for them and allow us to deliver the food at their home, and they allowed our homemakers to go their home rather than they come to our center. So that makes us possible for them to serve and to really give them food and all the necessary services which they otherwise, I think many were so much dying with the depression and loneliness and without food. Food is such an essential thing for, especially for ethnic seniors, because they do not eat outside food. They cannot eat any McDonald's or Taco Bell or something or something. So that's why I'm very, very thankful for the government also. And my staff came out with the risking their lives, and they cook the food right there, and the drivers took the food all over. And I have to thank Basinta, our Mukherjee, Mr. President Mukherjee.
Jayanta Mukherjee.
He offered his services voluntarily to deliver the food in Vernon Hills, in the Lake County, every day at Vinita Gulwani. She was the first person who really donate so much food, because we needed more than we had a supply.
Wow.
But they are the first person who have given the supply to us.
Wow.
We have one, everybody, they are with our member or not member. So we needed more food. So thank you, Vinita, very much. Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Vijay. I think it's all done by, our leader is no dynamic.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Now we'll have the guest of honor remarks by the one and only Congressman Raja Krishnamurti from the 8th District of Illinois.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
It's so nice to be with you, and I just wanted to observe those three rules of public speaking. Be short, be sweet, and be gone. So I have three points that I want to make. First of all, can you give a big round of applause to Congressman Danny Davis? So I'm so proud to call Danny not just a colleague, not just a friend, but a mentor. A mentor not only for me, but a mentor for everyone in this room. Am I right about that?
Yeah.
He gives the voice to the voiceless. He gives strength to the weak. He gives hope to those who feel destitute. And he is a good man.
All right.
Now you may be watching him talk about the census, but really what he does is he gets us in Congress to come to our senses. Whether it's aid to the poor, whether it's fighting COVID, whether it's making sure health care is within reach of everybody, Danny Davis is that man who speaks up for people who couldn't be there themselves. And for that, we are so grateful. Now, Danny, he's also a superhero. You see, he wears that cape. And I think that shows his true colors.
Yes.
Red, white, and blue.
Yes.
We are a united country, and that is why it's only appropriate that he heads the Multiethnic Advisory Task Force. Is that right about that?
Yes. Yes.
We are united.
Yes.
We are united. Yes. Regardless of what this president does, we are united.
Yes. All right.
And we are united under Danny K. Davis.
All right.
Yes.
Now the second point I want to make is about Chief. I could go on and on about Dr. Vijay Prabhakar. who is affectionately known as Chief and who calls each of us Chief. Of course, as you know, as our community, sometimes people say there are too many chiefs and not enough Indians. But in this case, when he talks about us being a chief, he's bestowing respect. And we need more people like that in our community who bestow respect on each other and treat each other with dignity and grace and try to help each other. I joked the other day, when you're in trouble, you call 1-800-VIJAY. And then the third and final point. Look, all of you are some of the finest people I know. You care about this community. You care about your country. And it touches me to hear the stories about people who needed food and you were there for them. Who needed comfort and you were there for them. Who needed a friend and you were there for them. And for that, I don't think anybody could possibly overstate your importance today in this pandemic, in this time when there's so much need. We've never seen this amount of need before. And so for that, I say thank you. And so I just close with my favorite saying, which is that yesterday is history, tomorrow's a mystery, but today is a gift. That's why we call it the present. And so I'm so honored and blessed to celebrate you on his, he's not even 80. He's not even close. He's so young, and he's our congressman for life. Thank you so much. God bless.
Thank you so much, Congressman Raja. And now I'll call upon Gerard Moore, our staff director of METF and the deputy district director for Congressman, to propose the champagne toast. The mic is there. Here, next to Congressman.
And the Congressman.
If everyone can stand, if you haven't drunk your champagne already, we're going to give a toast to Congressman Davis. Is it all right if I start talking, or do
yes,
I
wait? Yes, go ahead.
Okay. Well, Congressman Davis, on behalf of the Multiethnic Advisory Task Force, we pray that God continue to give you wisdom, give you direction, and to give you strength. And you continue to be a great leader and a great visionary for all of us. So we're going to toast to Congressman Davis. Happy birthday, and we pray that God bless you and many more. Robert, you can't drink with the master.
To assist Congressman Danny K. Davis to cut his 79th
birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
All of this personal attention.
Hey, quiet, please.
Please, hello.
All of this personal attention is kind of difficult for me. It really is. Part of it is because by nature, I am a rather shy individual. I spend a lot of time with introspection, and that is inside of me. And I can spend a whole day, for example, and not talk to anybody, not say a word, and be just as happy as one would need to be. Plus, I'm not really given to a lot of comfort thing. It's cool for whoever really are. I've never been. I just am that I am.
Right on.
But I've been most fortunate in life. First of all, to have lived for 79 years.
Amen.
With life expectancy, you know, is about around there now for some 100. People. Not really for African American males, though. Not for black men.
For angels.
In America. So, I've done all right.
Yes.
Yes, you have.
In that arena. But by getting involved in public life, I've met and interacted with so many outstanding people. And I've never wanted to be like anybody. I've never wanted to be envious of anybody. I've never wanted to do what anybody else have done. I just wanted to be me.
All right.
Whatever me is. The Multiethnic Advisory Task Force. And I admit that I've been all over the world just about, never been to India. The longest airplane ride I ever had was 24 hours.
Now it's 16 hours.
To Sri Lanka.
Now it's only 16 hours.
Oh yeah. And I've been obviously to China and a bunch of other places in the Pacific and South America. Since. Never been to India. I do want to go to India. I want to go to India at one point and see it. But I want to think somebody's always got to be creative enough to envision something. And I know that much of the vision for the activity in which we're involved has come from Dr. Vijay.
Yep.
Yes. Not alone. I mean, there have been others as well. Keyshaw, been on the set for all the time.
Thank you.
But let me tell you, at the end of the day, people like Roger and myself and some of you recognize that thoughts and ideas without power doesn't really mean much.
Yeah.
And the way to make things happen and get things done is to develop power. If you don't have any, then you're just kind of spouting powwow. There's a big difference between power and powwow. The greatest and most effective acquisition of power is something called unification. If you can unify, then you can have power and influence. And if you can have enough of whatever it is that you've got to spread around, I love it when I see a new bill that Roger has introduced. Or when I get a call from his office saying, can you sign on to Representative Krista Morty's bill to do so and so and so. Or when I look in the Sun Times and see that Roger has a story written about him, as I did the other week when I saw that he has been the lead in this country, pushing to try and and convince young people and others that vaping is not good for their health.
All right.
The lead, not a person signing on, not a person following behind. You can always follow the crowd, but there isn't much cheer and always looking at somebody else's rear. and so leading, going where there is no path and blazing a trail.
All right.
Roger is smart enough, astute enough, young enough. If he stays in the House, he could certainly become the Speaker of the House.
Yeah!
The opportunity presents itself, he could certainly become a United States Senator from Illinois. Yeah. Or if he decides he wants to do local government stuff, he could certainly be the governor. And, well, let me
How about the mayor?
You decide to do things based upon what it is that you want to accomplish. And you survey the land. And you make the most appropriate decision. So it's not really something that people do willy-nilly. Not every dead serious about it. Because no matter how much we have done, when I get ready to eat at night or in the daytime, I often will say a little blessing. And I'll often say, Lord, there are so many people in the world who have an appetite, but no food. Mm. But there are millions of others who have food, but no appetite. And so no matter what it is that we do, we never do enough. There are millions of hungry people in our world right now. We've got cake. There are millions of children practically starving.
Yes.
In our world right now.
In America.
There are millions of people sick and cannot get to a doctor. Cannot get health care. Millions. I'm not talking about thousands. I'm talking about millions. And so no matter what we have accomplished, my mother used to tell us that anybody who gets too carried away with what they've already done would never realize how much there is to do. And so all of us are called to greatness. All of us. Dr. King was so right when he said that everybody can be great because everybody can. One group that I belong to said that he who would be the greatest of all would be the servant of all. All of us have that potential for greatness. So I thank you for giving me the opportunity to share your lives with you. To share your work, your hopes. Dr. Reddy is one of those creative doctors who were doing plasma treatment for COVID-19 before Trump ever heard of it. No, I'm telling the truth. Sounds like a joke, but we had a press conference at least 2 or 3 months ago with a group of physicians, many of them members of the Chicago Medical Society, who come up with the plasma treatment. That is, individuals who've already experienced COVID to get the plasma from them and use it to treat others. The president had a press conference the other week, made like it was a great big new breakthrough. And I'm sitting there saying, damn. I know that's the same thing. We had our press conference at least 2 months ago up on the north side at the Life Source Blood Center where they take the blood. So beware. My last thing that I will say is really thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. All of you and all of us. We have an election in November, and we have a great opportunity. Our country is on the verge of moving forward or moving backward. We talk about elections having consequences. Let me tell you, people in this country have worked hundreds of years to just get some of the minor concessions that we've been able to create. And we've got a fella in the White House trying to tear all of those down. The Affordable Care Act was the best thing that happened to health care after the Indians discovered cornflakes. And he wants to lead the dismantling and destruction of it. When I was a kid and where I lived growing up, there was one doctor in the county, Dr. Crandall. He drove a Model T Ford. He looked like Doc Adams on Gunsmoke. He had a black bag. And many people, when they got sick, if they had to go to the doctor and pay him, depending on what he would treat you for, you give him a watermelon. Or you give him a bushel of corn. Or you go out in the field and pick a bushel of crowded peas. If it was in the wintertime, you give him half a slab of bacon from the pig that you had slaughtered. America has come a long way. We cannot afford to go back. We cannot afford to go back. So I would simply encourage us to all be as engaged between now and November the 3rd as we can possibly be.
Sure.
So that at the end of that day, we can look at this flag.
Yes,
we can look at this flag and not only sing but say, my country, tis of thee, sweet land of liberty. Of thee I sing, of thee I pray, of thee we shall have. Please eat some of this cake. Don't let it go to waste.
No.
I'm a type 2 diabetic, so I'm going to as much as I hate to, but all of you healthy people, have a little peace. If it was Frank Sinatra, he'd say, drink up. All you happy people, order anything you see. Cost the drinks and the laughs on me. So thank you so much.
Davis, as you rightly said, you know, about poverty, about healthcare, and we as a group, the American Multiethnic Coalition, as well as the Multiethnic Advisory Task Force, today, September 6, 2020, on the 79th birthday of our beloved Congressman, have a historic announcement to make. With God's help and his blessings, we plan to have announced the Danny K. Davis Multiethnic Community Center, which will be opening soon, a 64,000 square feet facility in Bellwood. And that would house all community programs for, you know, the Indian community, the Chinese community, the Korean community, the Assyrian community have their old community centers. But a multi-ethnic community centers, first of its kind in the country, will be named after Danny K. Davis Multi-Ethnic Community Center. Thank you for all your comments and support and blessings for that. I'd like Dr. Reddy to add a few words, and then Mrs. Santosh Kumar would also say a few words, as they are the lead trustees for the program.
You know, I'm not prepared to say anything, but I think it's a great idea. It's a great idea. You know, one thing that I just briefly mentioned, he's so open to listening to any human being, irrespective of race, religion, and where you came from. That clearly exemplifies all the mix of people. Raja, I just spoke to all of them, and I told. Clearly exemplifies the mix of people that we see here. You know, it's great, you know, you have a good heart, very compassionate, and you have this vision to improve the human welfare. That's an amazing thing. And I think this community center will come into fruition. That would help so many people of immigrant population across the Illinois. And I think I humbly request, and let's make this reality come true.
Oh my gosh.
Thank you.
Right.
Thank you, Dr. Vijay, for bringing this thing up. And thank you, Dr. Our Danny Davis. This is the thought which our multi-ethnic has been thought. Because generally, we become very sectarian, generally. Chinese have their own, Indians have their own, Koreans have their own. But multi-task is the only organization which can embrace everybody, no matter which country you belong to. Because this country, America, has at least 198 countries minimum. And anybody can be the part of that. If they need something, if we can provide it, that is the thought behind it. And I hope with the blessing of Danny Davis and Raja, because we need your blessings also. In the sense that generally we want to be broader and more inclusive to everybody. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Excellent. Thank you.
Okay, everybody.